Hi everyone, it's Sunday night, the 21st of June, and day 173 of Living the Dream. Now I'm embarrassed to say this, but I just realized that Friday night and yesterday, Saturday night, I said the wrong date and the wrong number of days for my Living the Dream. Friday night I said it was the 20th of June and day 172. And then Saturday night I said it was the 21st of June and day 173 of Living the Dream. On both nights I misspoke the date and the number of days. For that, I apologize. Maybe you don't understand this or you don't do this yourself, but with my days all being like Saturdays and having just one Sunday, so six Saturdays and a Sunday, I forget what day it is many times, for more often than I would like, and that leaves me vulnerable to this kind of date switching in my head. I can't believe it. Tonight, when I was looking at my computer, I noticed the date down in the bottom right corner of my screen, and it said the 21st of June. Oh my goodness, I was startled. I realized I was ahead of myself by one day, and so I went back to see when I got off track and found that Thursday night I was correct with my date and numbers, but starting Friday night and then last night, I had to correct myself because I said the wrong date and the wrong number. So I'm glad I'm back on the right track. Please forgive me. Anyway, I wanted to correct myself going forward, but I decided to just leave my mishaps on those videos as they were and just start with the correct date tonight going forward. And so as you can tell, perfection is not ever going to be my claim to fame. That's for darn sure. In reading my power statement this morning, it said, after my win the morning, win the day routine, I will start my day of sharpening the saw. I will enjoy a day of Father's Day enjoyment. I literally took the day off, basically, and that was made possible by my sweet wife, Kathleen. Just as I was finishing my exercise this morning, Kathleen came to me with a dinner tray filled with an incredible breakfast for the both of us, which we sat down on our double wide and proceeded to enjoy together. That was a hint of how the entire day was going to go. I need to show you my to-do list. Here's Sunday's to-do list. Fun, Father's Day family, carpool. That was the fun test on my list. I kind of knew about the secret, so I put that down. And second, my exciting task was to watch some videos on a few things that I was just curious about, and so I watched them. And then all day long, sharpen the saw. Done. As you can see, my to-do list was very short. Just had those two or three highlighted tasks, and it was all about sharpening the saw, sharpening the saw, sharpening the saw. Next Christ says, get honest with yourself. What didn't go well today, Marty? Or what could you have done better today? Did you wake up early and start strong? I still got up strong, 6:30, still got up strong. Did you start your morning with power? Were you productive throughout your day? No, I wasn't productive. I was kind of basically a couch potato, a slug, enjoying all the fun and the festivity. It was great. Did you get the most important things done today? Yes, I was a father, once again. Absolutely. Did you move your goals forward? Sharpen the saw? Absolutely. Anything else? No. Did you show up as the person you wanted to? Yes, I did. I was kind. I was happy. I was so grateful and so appreciative. Absolutely showed up how I wanted to be. What about your personal time with Kathleen? It was all day long. It was fantastic. Were you present? I was 100% there. After I answered these questions, I always like to ask myself this get honest with yourself question. Were you honest with yourself about today's task, Marty? Did you keep your commitments and promises you made this morning? Well, like I said, today was a total day of making me feel special and appreciated by my family. As you know, my Sundays are for me to do those things that will help sharpen my saw, or for me to not do things that would keep me from sharpening my saw. Because it was Father's Day today, that was the easiest thing to do, because I pretty much enjoyed a day of relaxing, reading with Kathleen, talking to her about things that she wanted to talk about, and talking about things that I wanted to talk to her about and get her thoughts and feelings. It was a fantastic day, and it was a day of seeing my children and their families. So I most definitely kept my promise to myself to sharpen my saw. The next question is, what movies did you watch in your mind today, Marty? Did you make time for them? And were there any new movies that your two amigos put onto the screen of your mind during the day today? In other words, did you make new movies today? And if so, what were they about? Well, I went to the movies this morning during my mindfulness time. I always do it. It's a habit. I don't miss it. But that was pretty much it, because before I knew it, it was lunchtime, and Kathleen had prepared a fantastic lunch for us, and my brother, who came to have lunch with us, we enjoyed it together. And then after that late lunch, I think it was like 2, I went back to the recliner and took a brief nap. And during my nap, Kathleen got up and prepared for a secret Father's Day parade that I talked about, that she had set up with all the kids and their families. Each family was to be in their car and line up a couple blocks away, one behind each other, and then at a certain time at 4 o'clock, they were supposed to drive up and spend 5 minutes right in our driveway, their windows down, and the parade, like I said, started at 4, and one car after another, every 5 to 7 minutes, came and chatted, and we hand them a nice pie, a 4 variety of pie, banana cream or lemon meringue or blueberry, whatever. They each had pies. Kathleen already knew what their choices were, and she had them all laid out, and I just kind of gave out napkins and said hi, and they said hi, 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 and love, 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 and so bam, 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 bam. 6 cars were all there for a while, and within 30 minutes, they were all gone. That was too short for me, but some were concerned about the virus and how it might run the risk for me, and so, because I'm 65, soon to be 66, and so I'm very happy I was able to at least see them for that brief time and say hello and blow them kiss and to see their faces and see their delight. It was fantastic. Kathleen, I love you. You're the best. The rest of the afternoon, Kathy and I relaxed and watched a few video YouTube clips and talked about them and Jody Moore video. And I think we even watched a couple of America's Got Talent performances that were fantastic. And before we knew it, it was time to listen to our end of the day success routine. Boop, the day was gone. Next, Corey asked, was there anything that didn't go well today, Marty? In other words, was there one thing you could have done better? What one thing would that all make all the difference going forward? And then he said, in another way to put it is, what's the one thing you'd want to get done tomorrow that even if your day goes sideways doing it, you'd still feel like success because you got it done? What would that one thing be? And once you've decided what that one thing is, turn it into a power statement for tomorrow morning, so you can start your day strong. Today was a perfect day. I couldn't have made it any better. I do wish we didn't have to concern ourselves with the COVID-19 issue. Can't do a thing about that. That way everyone would have been able to stay and talk and enjoy and laugh and enjoy more time together. But I'm sure we'll be able to start doing that in the near future. At least I sure hope so. Anyway, my power statement that I came up with said this: I will make sure that I do something to connect with my children every week, and not wait until some holiday comes around. I decided on this power statement because after today and given it some reflection, I was reminded what really matters most, and so I wanted to keep this connecting up going forward. I mean, I already do call my children here and there, and they call me here and there. I mean, I talked about little Huxley, a little 2-year-old, and his dad calling us in the morning on Duo a couple, 3 times a week. So we have that connection. It's great. And so we also have a family messenger group chain where everyone sends text to each other, and that's where we keep up what's going on and that, and some text here and some reply there and some do funny little gifts and all that kind of thing coming on our group messenger texting. But I'm referring to a one-on-one between me and each individual child and each individual grandchildren, so that I have at least one time a week that I can express my love for them and connect with them in a very personal one-on-one way. So that's what I'm talking about. It may get difficult, but with today's technology, I'm thinking I'm going to be able to do it. We'll see. That's going to be the effort anyway. Next, Corey asks, were there any mistakes or failures I had or made today that I can turn into a tool of success going forward? And like I said earlier, today was a perfect day. I wasn't trying to get things done or even do anything, really. And so my chances of failure or making a mistake were pretty slim to none. The next item is to rate my day's effort. I gave today a 10. I say 10 because my wife certainly worked at the speed of 10 to make my Father's Day pretty special. And so as far as I'm concerned, she hit it out of the park. Way to go, Kathleen. Okay, I want to end the day strong. Here's what I'm grateful for today. Today I'm grateful for brand new pillows. They're huge, I didn't bring them in. For Father's Day, Kathleen got me 2 brand new pillows. They're incredible pillows. One for her side of the bed, one for my side of the bed. My wife knows me well. We've been talking about how our pillows have gotten pretty worn down over the last few years, so that they seem to be too hard, even almost like rocks. But that was months ago. But Kathleen didn't forget it. She got me several other things as well, but I can't be more happy and or more thrilled than I am for those 2 pillows. Next, I'm grateful for the law of success called action. In other words, be a person of action. Leonardo da Vinci said, "It had long since come to my attention that people of accomplishment rarely sat back and let things happen to them." In other words, success didn't attack him. They went out and happened to things. They attacked success. That's the truth. Though da Vinci said this centuries ago, it worked just as much today as it ever did. This principle applies to literally any successful person you can think of. Think about it. Picture someone like William Shakespeare, for example. When we think of the time he lived in, we think that that time was shaped by him. When we think of the Renaissance era Italy, we think of Michelangelo and Leonardo da Vinci and how they shaped their time as well. Now think about the present day. Think about Bill Gates or Steve Jobs. Our current way of life would simply be incomparable. It'd be incomparably different if they didn't accomplish what they accomplished. In fact, you're probably reading or watching this video on a device or using software that was developed by a company they owned, or they either founded, or by companies they were influenced by them. All these figures were proactive. They saw ways to do things differently, and they went out and did them. Person of action. If they had let the world shape them, then they simply would have slipped back into the background. Instead, they shaped the world. Next, I'm grateful for the principle of coloring outside of the lines. Let's apply the law of action, this being a person of action, and being a person of action to you and me. Let's say this, my message here, in other words, don't be afraid of going outside the norm. If you can think of a better way to do something, then do it that way. If you fail, try again. Get up and try again. Get up and try again. Developing this kind of sing the song that is within you by being a person of action is definitely living the dream. If you have a song to sing, sing it. If you have a bell to ring, ring it. If you have a story to tell, tell it. I had an experience to tell, and so I am telling it as I'm on my journey to Business Alignment doing these video journal entries. Anyway, until tomorrow night when I'll be right back here at my computer and my laptop, sharing my heartfelt feelings of the day, I wish you continued success. Until then, good night.